My late husband used to have greyhounds long before I ever met him. Had got out of them, had nothing to do with them in the sort of few years before I met him, and rang me at work one day. I'm after buying a greyhound, and I thought, lovely, what are we going to do with that? We have a Jack Russell and a cat. So, and the rest is history. That was Granada girl Sally, our first greyhound, and we had her from puppyhood till she was 15. That was sort of, it evolved out of nowhere really, but here we are. Well, at the moment all my dogs are retired. And I'm retired myself, so we have a lazy day. We start at around 7. I get up and let the dogs out first, having had a little sausage first for a taste, a treat. And then from there, it's out for their run around and toilet and whatever. Back in, while I have my tea and toast, they chill out, and then I get their breakfast, which consists mainly of porridge, some dog nuts, varied with some cheese, some eggs. Nice, healthy variety, tasty breakfast for them. It's a mundane life to a certain extent, but it's a dog's life really and truly. I mean, unless you have race dogs or you have dogs that are working dogs, well, what do most people do with their dogs really? And people are fascinated that, gosh, you know, you don't have to walk them for 10 miles or you don't have to, you know, do an awful lot of work with them. Plus the fact they're fascinated with the fact that they don't have to go to the groomers and they don't require an awful lot of extra fussy attention. And people's reaction is mixed. Some people then are very much, you know, why have you got greyhounds? And, you know, when they hear you race them, they're not too keen on that. And then I explain that, you know, greyhounds and greyhound racing are fine if greyhounds are looked after well, if they're well treated, well cared for. Look at my dogs, they've all been racing. And they looked like this when they were racing. They were as well cared for when they were racing. So I've got involved with the Retired Greyhound Trust. We've gone on dog walks. We've had pet shows. We've had, you know, retired greyhound shows. We've participated in, I've taken them to the tracks to promote them as pets for various fundraiser nights that we've been on, and fundraisers for the guide dogs for the blind. Anywhere I could bring the greyhounds to be seen as the same as your average pet dog. Through the Greyhound Trust, I've rehomed to Italy, to Belgium, to Sweden. All of mine have gone with a letter and details of my contact details. All of mine have gone to very good homes, and the main thing being that I've been able to keep in touch with everybody. And everybody that has my dogs have contacted me. Some of the people actually have come and stayed here and come back to visit. They're socialised from so young. They really are a breed of dog that get on well with and are safe with everybody really, but with children they're a gentle dog, and they actually, they love the hugs, the kisses. That the kids like to hug dogs, so good pet, good family pet. And all of mine that have gone abroad, most of them I would say live with families where they have young children, they have cats, they have other small dogs, no problem. You know, as a breed they are not aggressive, they're not aggressive to other dogs, they get on very well with even with cats. I mean, some of the people who have some of my dogs abroad have cats, and I have pictures of the dog and cat eating from the same bowl, lying down side by side. So the myth that you can't have a greyhound with a cat or can't have them with a small dog is a myth. I mean, the collie I have here at the moment, she was a puppy when they were fully grown dogs, and she ran around with them. They never ever harmed her. I mean, she grew up with them. But even I've brought in stray dogs that, you know, I've taken in, fostered and rehomed and whatever, and they have welcomed every dog that's come in here into the house.